Saturation divers work far out in the North Sea. They're offshore for weeks at a time. These are the men who actually work on the seabed. On duty, they can spend up to 5 weeks at pressures artificially created to match what they'll find hundreds of feet down. They spend up to half their time working. For the rest, there's nothing much to do but eat, read, and sleep. In these cramped quarters on deck, there's both a physical and psychological strain. So every week spent in saturation earns them a week off work on shore. The pay is high too, up to £500 a week, but the earning life of a diver is a short one. Most get out in their early 30s. In saturation, the air they breathe is a mixture of 2% oxygen and 98% helium. The gas saturates the body tissue, and at the end of a diving trip, it will take 5 days in saturation to bring their bodies back to normal. The helium has one other effect. It distorts the divers' voices. Their colleagues on deck control everything. The pressure, temperature, and air supply inside the chamber and the diving bell.
Riser, and you'll be taking off an old riser clamp, and then we'll be putting on the new clamp.
When their shift begins, the bell is locked on to the saturation chamber for the divers to enter. Inside, they put on their suits, which, like the bell itself, are heated by hot water. The bell, lowered on the main lift cable, is guided down on wires attached to a large piece of metal called the clump weight, another of whose functions is to hold the bell a few feet off the seabed. The hot water, air, power, and communications are all supplied to the bell through a collection of tubes, the bell's umbilical. The main hazard of the North Sea is the cold. Even a brief interruption in the supply of hot water would be fatal. The divers take it in turns to work outside. Even this cramped bell will seem a welcome haven after 4 hours of exhausting work. 500 feet down, visibility almost nil, they lose their sense of colour and half their sense of touch.